Hi, I'm Bunny Harder, a queer and trans VTuber, and I'm calling for an immediate ceasefire in Gaza and for a free Palestine. Join me, please, in standing in solidarity with the Palestinian people and in taking action right now for peace. Like you, I believe in a world where people from all cultures, backgrounds, and communities can live in freedom, in dignity, and with justice. And for more than 75 years, the people of Palestine have been denied all three. Forced from their homes, denied the right to return, crammed into ever-shrinking refugee camps, apartheid prisons, and pockets of land, faced with ethnic cleansing after ethnic cleansing and with massacre after massacre. For more than 75 years, much of the world has done little to prevent this. And now, it's culminating in an act of genocide we're watching unfold in the palms of our hands. There is a future where anyone of any background can drive in peace from Jerusalem to Gaza, and that future begins with an immediate ceasefire, with the end of the Israeli occupation, and with the liberation of Palestine and of the Palestinian people. We can help to make this future happen. You can help to make this future happen. Don't stop talking about this. Don't stop protesting. Don't stop striking. Take action to stop this genocide now and to show the world and Palestinians that we won't look away this time. It's important to be informed as well. If you're looking to learn more about this conflict, I recommend a Jewish Voice for Peace's About section, and their FAQ is a place to start. You can find that at jewishvoiceforpeace.org, and the book The 100 Years War in Palestine by Rashid Khalidi. Before I go, I want to share the words of Palestinian poet Refaat Alareer. This is If I Must Die. If I must die, you must live, to tell my story, to sell my things, to buy a piece of cloth and some strings, make it white with a long tail, so that a child somewhere in Gaza, while looking heaven in the eye, awaiting his dad who left in a blaze, and bid no one farewell, not even to his flesh, not even to himself, sees the kite, my kite, you made, flying up above, and thinks, for a moment, that an angel is there, bringing back love. If I must die, let it bring hope. Let it be a tale. Refaat was killed alongside his family by an Israeli airstrike on December 7th. This was his last poem. Let it bring hope. Let it be a tale.
Hi, minasan. I'm FlowerBomber from Japan. People all over the world, including many Japanese, have realized that the genocide in Gaza should stop. Thanks to my online friends who talk about what's happening in Palestine and stand up for you, I also realized what is happening to you. And I was inspired by one of them, Bunny Hearted Sensei, and I drew her wearing the kufiya to show solidarity. 日本は政治的にイスラエル軍を助けるアメリカの影響下にあります。それでも日本社会にもだんだんとこの戦争に戦闘性がないことが広まりつつあります。Nobody should treat your lives like bags. Nobody has the right to steal your futures. Nobody should ignore Gaza. I want to say in my language, 川から海まで、パレスチナ自由になれ。You are not alone, 皆さん。
Hello, my name is Isabel, and I'm here to tell you a story. There is a location known as Palestine that has been under the threat of another location known as Israel. Now, the things that Israel has been doing to the Palestinians has been completely just disgraceful in its disdain for basic human life. There are several hundreds, thousands more innocent civilians getting shelled, getting shot, getting killed every day in that location. Hell, as I speak, there's probably more dying right now. It is our responsibility to have the voices that are being silenced be heard across the world. It is such an atrocity, an outrage, that it just angers me. But I don't let it doom me, and it shouldn't doom you either. Let it let it inspire you to do good in this world, to share the voices of these innocent people, the lives, their experiences, all of it. Because it is just the right thing to do. It just is. From the river to the sea, Palestine will be free.
Hello there. I'm known as Briley, and I'm raising my voice in solidarity with Palestine in calling for an immediate ceasefire. This multi-generational conflict has evolved into a full-on genocide. It is not something that we can just simply ignore or look away from, because this is happening to so many people. So many people are being displaced, killed, for crying out loud. I am just one of the many, many people who have learned more about what's going on, what's happening in Gaza, and have begun speaking up more and more. It's just something we can't really turn a blind eye to. It's not right. I've been doing my part in encouraging others to contact their elected representatives to also push for a ceasefire. It's not enough that just citizens are calling for the ceasefire. We need the people that are supposed to be running our government for our interests to also start actually sharing and expressing those interests. And a big part of that would be calling for the ceasefire in Gaza. Every single person deserves to live a life of peace and dignity.
Hi, I'm Nerdy Nanny, and I'm joining the call for a ceasefire. Let me try and get through this in the best way that I can. In times of conflict, it's crucial that we recognize our shared humanity, irregardless of our differences. It's easy to become entrenched in your position and see things one way or another. Let's not forget that there's innocent children, adults, and elderly folk who are being affected by this tragedy. They just want what we want. Peace, security, and a hope for the future. Today I speak to you with a heartfelt plea for a ceasefire in Palestine. The suffering of innocent lives caught in the conflict is undeniable, and the time has come for us to demand peace. This violence needs to stop. We have to step up. Lend us your voice. Answer the call. Ceasefire now. Yeah, fuck Zionists. And fuck Nazis. And fuck bigots. Fuck them all. Human rights matter. Plain and simple.
The past months, years, and even decades have been absolutely hellish for Palestinian people. I often try to express in words how much they've suffered, but I could never find one strong enough to actually convey how utterly despicably they were and still are treated by the Israeli government and military forces. Even something like genocide doesn't portray the scale of torture, war crimes, just deaths they've suffered. Anyone who knows even part of what happened to them should be standing with Palestine and people of Gaza to end their suffering and stop genocidal ways of Israel. The abuse, genocide, war crime, and decades-long occupation and eradication of Palestinian people has to stop, and has to stop now. From the river to the sea, Palestine will be free.
Okay, people, I am part of Bunker Cat in normal language, and this is a message of solidarity to the Palestinians. Number one, from the river to the sea, Palestine will be free. We gonna say that, and we gonna keep saying it, even if we're not Palestinians. because it is a prayer to our Palestinian brothers and sisters. And we're going to keep saying it from the river to the sea, Palestine will be free. We're going to keep saying it no matter what they say, okay? And second, kind of lastly, I just want to talk about how, you know, whatever you do, no matter how small it is, you think it is, or how big you think it is, whatever you do, just keep doing it for Palestine, okay? Because, you know, they need to know that we're still on site when it comes to Palestine, that we're still, and also that we're still on their side, okay? Because they are facing one of the longest crises on earth. It's been almost a century, bro, that Palestinians have had to suffer. So we need to keep showing solidarity in whatever means you can, whoever you are. If you're good at this, do this. If you're good at that, do that. If you could do media, do media. Don't think that you're not doing much. If you could do activism, do activism. If you could raise money, if that's your specialty, if your specialty is medicine, you know, medical, do that. If you could do this, do this. If you're a marketing person, there is whatever little skills that you have, just do it, right? In whatever little time that you have, free time that you have, just keep showing solidarity. I'm kind of happy seeing the new generation are so on point with how they are showing solidarity to the Palestinians. Just keep being yourself, bro. The new generation is different, bro. Because I've seen the older generation. It's a bit of a niche thing to be pro-Palestine. But the new generation are making it mainstream, okay? To be supportive of victims of whatever you want to call it. The G-side or whatever you want to call it. Like, of occupation, okay? So I'm just saying, creators, you know, activists, whatever you're doing, no matter how small or big, just keep doing it, okay? We are a diverse people. As people of Earth, we are a diverse people. Every one of us have our own specialities, our own character. So do what you can, kid. Like the song, DWYCK, do what you can, kid. You get me? So yeah, that's all I have to say about this. And keep showing your solidarity, because I'm pretty sure they need it. Even if it is just, you know, flying the flag and wearing the kefir, I'm pretty sure they need it at the very least as moral support, right? All right, from the river to the sea, Palestine will be free. You get me? All right, that's all for now. Peace.
Chimney tops, that's where I'm T, and this is Kara, and we're in VR chat. We're in a world called Palestine Gallery by Modison, and we want to encourage you to visit this world because it has a historical timeline of the Palestinian struggle and describes the decades of suffering that the Palestinian people have experienced under Israeli occupation. You can also contribute messages of support through the gallery. And we have two messages today. One message is to the Palestinian people. We've been watching in horror as Israel carries out its violent genocide on your people and occupies your land, extinguishing your lives and the dreams of your children.
Over the past 2 months, I've witnessed so much death and destruction in the Gaza Strip, and my heart is breaking for you, the people of Palestine. I wish there wasn't any conflict in the Middle East. We are all human beings, and we all deserve to live in peace and harmony. We should build each other up and not tear each other down. We want you to know that we support you. And we will call for a ceasefire. But we know that even if there is and when there is a ceasefire, nothing will bring back the 18,000 people who have been murdered since October, including 7,700 children. We will not forget you, and we will not forget the thousands who have been injured and displaced.
Our second message is to people around the world who live outside of Palestine. I want to read a quote from the writer Mohammed Al-Kurd, who lives within occupied Jerusalem. He says, "If you're non-Palestinian, hang the Palestinian flag from your window. Get an anti-Zionist bumper sticker. Put the Palestinian flag in your social media bio. Join a Palestinian organization. Gift someone a book on Palestine. Visible solidarity, albeit often symbolic, is needed in a climate so hostile to us." I also want to encourage you, if you're receiving most of the information about this situation through mainstream news sources, to supplement or even replace that with the social media accounts of Palestinian reporters, journalists, and civilians who are on the ground. There are a couple you can follow. There's Wizard Bizan, Noor Harazin, and there's also an American activist, Sean King, who reposts and shares and has links to other journalists in Palestine. Finally, we'd like to read a poem by Dr. Refaat Alareer, who was a Palestinian poet, scholar, and activist, murdered during an Israeli airstrike on December 7th, 2023, and who was survived by his wife and children. The poem is called I Am You, and it was written to the Israeli soldiers.
Look in the mirror. Horror, the horror. The butt of your M16 on my cheekbone. The yellow patch, it left. The bullet-shaped scar expanding. Like a swastika. Sneaking across my face. The heartache flowing. Out of my eyes, dripping. Out of my nostrils, piercing. My ears flooding the place like it did to you 70 years ago or so.
I am just you. I am your past, haunting your present and your future. I strive like you did. I fight like you did. I resist like you resisted. And for a moment, I take your tenacity as a model for you not holding the barrel of the gun between my bleeding eyes.
The very same gun, the very same bullet that had killed your mom and killed your dad is being used against me by you.
Mark this bullet. And mark it in your gun. If you sniff it, it has your and my blood. It has my present and your past. It has my present.
It has your future. That's why we are twins. Same life track, same weapon, same suffering, same facial expressions drawn. On my face of the killer, same everything, except that in your case, the victim has evolved backward into a victimizer. I tell you, I am you, except that I am not the you of now.
I do not hate you. I want to help you stop hating and killing me. I tell you, the noise of your machine gun renders you deaf. The smell of the powder beats that of my blood. The sparks disfigure my facial expressions. Would you stop shooting for a moment? Would you?
All you have to do is close your eyes. Seeing these days blind our hearts, close your eyes tightly so that you can see in your mind's eye, then look into the mirror. One, two, I am you. I am your past. And killing me, you kill you.
From the river to the sea,
Palestine
will be free.
Can't you see that you are sweet? Oh, let me love you so. All are down, find a way out of this world, this comforting cage. Time to run and play the never give up forever.
It has been 2 months now. 2 months in addition to 75 years. Palestinians haven't been safe on their own land for 75 years. And in the last 2 months, the entire world turned their gaze upon the Gaza Strip. My thoughts are with all Palestinians right now. Those having to fear bombings and IOF attacks every hour of the day in the Gaza Strip. Those living in the occupied West Bank, facing oppression by Israeli soldiers and displacement by settlers without any respite, and those all around the world who have always encountered racism and othering by those successfully fooled by Israeli propaganda into thinking Palestinians are not human. You are one of the strongest people in the world, and I wish you didn't have to be. I wish for a future in which every Palestinian can go to their homeland without fear and live without being discriminated. The world is not closing their eyes to your suffering anymore. The propaganda isn't working anymore. We see the genocide happening. We see who is committing it. And we refuse to be silent about it. The people are standing up to their governments demanding a ceasefire now. And we will keep demanding it. And we will not stop talking about it. And we will keep going out on the streets despite our governments trying to shut us down. We won't stop until Palestine is free, from the river to the sea.